Welcome to Next Trains.
I got this locomotive off eBay. I didn't quite like the newer China versions, so it had to be an old version, and I happened to pick up the oldest one, that is 1990-1991 model. The running number is 2300. It's quite difficult to find these old model in new or in near mint condition. So this one was an used one, but in good working condition and as well as in good cosmetic condition. Funnily enough, me and the locomotive are approximately of the same age, that is about 26-year-old, that is in the year 1990/1991. But then as I placed her on track and used on the controller, she did not move. So I bought the loco on my work table and toppled it to side, took off the shell. There was one screw underneath the coal bunker and the shell came off easily. At first I couldn't find anything wrong with any of the wirings or connections, and so I placed her back on the track and tried to run her for the second time. And this time she did come to life and ran a short distance. I did notice a spark in the rear trailer bogey region, and now it is quite evident that there is some kind of short circuit occurring in the rear trailing pony. But then this was hardly enough to diagnose the problem, and so I had to test her for the third time. But this time she did not run and instead went up in smoke. This was something that had happened to me for the very first time. By now, I had lost all hopes of running her ever again. But then at the same time, I was quite reluctant of sending her all the way back to England. I wasn't quite willing to part away from her. And so, this meant I had no choice but to dismantle the tiniest of the tiny part in the locomotive and be sure to reassemble it as it was. I couldn't have dared disassemble my locomotive without the help of the James May's reassembling video of the Flying Scotsman. Link is given in the description. I did manage to put her back and she now runs very sweetly. I worked on the connecting rods. I had to take them apart fully and then reassemble piece by piece and make sure that the wheels are rotating correctly in synchrony with the connecting rods. Then I worked on the motor and the wiring parts, the pickups, the brushes, the armature and all that kind of stuff. I cleaned them thoroughly to the extent possible and then reassembled all these parts back. And now it was time to fix the shorting occurring in the rear trailing bogey. One of the most important points to note about these old locomotives is that this kind of particular ones had complete or full metal chassis. So that means if there are no proper insulations, the loco is going to short. This had two axles. I swapped the axles one at a time, and it was quite evident that the rearmost axle was causing the short. So I replaced one of the plastic wagon wheels that was of the same diameter and swapped the metal wheel into the wagon. Just to rule out the possibility of shorting further, I used toothpick as an axle instead of the metal axle that was supplied as original with the locomotive. I retained the original metal axle in the box. As stated earlier, she now runs sweetly. This is the locomotive running on rather dirty tracks. Otherwise, she stops and starts smoothly. That was a very joyful moment for me, and now this 26-year-old locomotive has got a nice home to stay in, where she'll be well loved and looked after. And being made of plastic and metal, she may even live longer than me.
And today, I have to make a video of the video.
Thank you for watching Nick's Trains. Please share with people who might like, appreciate and enjoy trains. Comment and subscribe.